Dolores O'Riordan sounded upbeat in a phone message she left for a friend hours before her death. Just hours before her sudden passing in London on Monday, 15 January 2018, the Cranberries frontwoman's friend Dan Waite, international managing director of 117 Music, who used to manage the Irish musician, received a voicemail from her on his phone. Waite shared in a statement to WIN that the Linger songstress sounded full of life the day before a studio session with hard rock band, Bad Wolves. Dolores left me a voice message just after midnight last night stating how much she loved Bad Wolves' version of Zombie. She was looking forward to seeing me in the studio and recording vocals, he wrote. She sounded full of life, was joking and excited to see me and my wife this week. The news of her passing is devastating and my thoughts are with Don, her ex-husband, her children, and her mother, he added. The 46-year-old singer was set to record her vocals the next day for the up-and-coming Los Angeles group's cover of the Cranberries' 1994 hit, Zombie. Zombie is an incredibly personal song. And we always felt the rawness and honesty she projected on stage and in her recordings was something to which all bands should aspire to. When we heard she wanted to sing on our version, it was the greatest compliment a band could receive, Bad Wolves singer Tommy Vext said in a statement. Dolores connected with the group after hearing their version of the track via her former management company, who now look after the Los Angeles rock group, and offered to add her own vocals. 117 Music CEO Alan Kovic added, "My heart goes out to her children. I hope they can find some peace despite this tragic event."